Hi guys. Yeah, this is Alozi, Chinne Alozi. And we are here today for the second webinar series. Yesterday we had the first one, and that was about acquire skill, study, and live in Canada. Today we are going to be looking at how embarking on research programs, graduate programs, can be a good way to facilitate actualizing your goals, your dream of living somewhere else than your primary country. Today, we are going to be looking more deep into how graduate programs, PhD programs, graduate programs, postdoctorate programs can be very, very good if you have such ambitions for those that are into academics. Graduate programs, PhD programs are more into research. And what is research all about? Research is all about solving a problem, picking up a problem and solving it, looking into the society, seeing what is hidden, what is still yet to be solved, and preferring a solution, looking into it and solving the problem. It could also be replicating an existing problem to show that the problem has been understood. Because the first step to solving a problem is knowing the problem, understanding the problem, and replicating the problem. Research is a bedrock. It's a bedrock for development. For any country, for any nation, for any company to continue growing, to continue advancing, to continue developing, such country must value what we call research and development. And that is what graduate studies is all about. So if traveling abroad, leaving your country to another country is your goal, and if Canada is that goal, then choosing to solve a problem, which means taking the path of graduate studies, could be an easy option to actualize that goal of living somewhere else, of seeing what it looks like to live somewhere else. And that is why in today's seminar series, I'll be looking extensively, exhaustively at the concept of graduate studies and research. I'm going to be putting up a slide in a short while, but I've just decided to establish a premise for this discussion. We've received several questions from our viewers, from our sign-ups, from those who signed up for this program, and we are hoping that we'll have sufficient time to attend to those questions today. However, we will try as much as possible to be fast and to be brief about the whole presentation series. So right now, I'm going to start up this presentation, and I'm going to give you an idea of how this presentation is going to go. Now, this is what the itinerary is going to look like. The first, I'm going to show you a flowchart, preamble, a flowchart of what it looks like, the path, the process, from the start point to your desired objective. The second, I'm going to show you why among the countries in the world, why Canada should be that destination you desire, why Canada should be your option. Thirdly, I'm going to show you what graduate programs are, the types of graduate programs, the options we have, and how you can harness and how you can take advantage of graduate programs to actualize your goal. I'm also going to show you the admission procedures, the application procedures, how you can be able to get your admission easily. And then after which, I also explain to you how you can plan yourself while you're doing your graduate program such that at the end of your graduate program, you have the ability, you have the capacity to land yourself a befitting job, which will pave way for your permanency. So I'm just going to quickly go to the slides for today. I may not be chronological, I may not flow the same way, but I will try as much as possible to capture the information that are necessary, and I believe everything is going to be fine. So if you have a question, you're free, you're welcome to submit your questions. You're going to have a question. Where's the question section? Just hold on a little bit and let me look for this. If you have a question, you're free to. Sorry, that's for the company. Just going to. Okay, these are question stuff. Yeah, that's it. If you have a question, you're welcome to send the questions in. We'll try as much as possible to answer all questions. Though we have the questions we're going to answer, we already have here. Just going to run straight to the presentation. Don't mind my voice. Going that right there now. Hold on, please. And that's going to be the share screen. Which screen am I going to share now? Okay, this one. Yep. That's it. Okay, awesome. I'm just going to go slideshow and then from current. Awesome. So this is a summary of the flow. This is a summary of what it looks like, of what you should be looking at, of what you are going to go through. So we have summary of flow, and the first step is graduate admission. The most common graduate admission you're going to see is a master's program, or you're looking at PhD program, doctorate program. Some people come for postdoctorate programs. These programs are called research-based programs. This is what we support because I really, really like research because I came to Canada through research. And I worked on hydraulic actuators, fault detection in valve-controlled and pump-controlled hydraulic actuators of aircrafts. And I use information-based processing methodologies like signal processing, fractals, Kalman filter to isolate faults, quantize faults, calibrate faults, and diagnose faults. Of course, it includes providing solution to an unknown problem, to an existing problem. And that is what research is all about. So I'm just going to go fast. That is just what you're coming to do. It may be in the science world, science field, it may be in the art field, any field. I'm just an engineering student. That's why I was using engineering elaborations, engineering instances. Probably that's what you hear, but that is my line. So after that, the next process, you're going to get postgraduate work permit. Well, I'm just going to run fast. This is going to come back. This slide. It's going to come back when I've gone through the process so you understand what it is and how to execute this process. So at the end of the first program, at the end of the first stage, you have the admission, you've run your program, you were successful, you wrote your papers, you have your degree, you are awarded the degree, you are awesome. The next step is what we call postgraduate work permit. Then you're going to get your postgraduate work permit. You're going to apply. If your program is more than 2 years, certainly. You get, it's going to be up to, you're going to get up to 3 years postgraduate work permit. Awesome for you. And when you get that postgraduate work permit, the next thing is to get a job. And we're going to highlight what you need to know about getting a job. We have gone through the same process, so it's just going to be, it's not going to be a difficult process. I'm going to explain that to you extensively. If you have a question, you're welcome to ask me. And the next step is going to be residency. Yeah, of course, you have a work, you have a job, then you have a permanent contract with your employer, And then you're going to be looking at residency, options, nomination, express of interest. I'm not an expert in that. I'm not just going to see about that. But I'm going to explain for you, to you, this is what we have done, and this is how it works. I'm going to go straight to the presentation. This section of the slide is going to be coming back later on, so you don't have to worry about this. I'm going to explain this later. So I'm just going to explain to you why I feel Canada should be the study destination for all. Canada is a very beautiful country with wildlife and vegetation. There is just nothing you want, you can see. If what you're looking for is to ski, if what you're looking for is to snowbait, if what you are looking for is so many grasses, if what you're looking for is beautiful vegetation, natural habitat, if what you're looking for is beautiful cities, very, very close to remote areas, if what you're looking for is beautiful schools that can admit over thousands of people, if what you're looking for is very small schools that can admit just 50 people, if what you're looking for is schools that are located in the hub of the city, where the cars are moving, where the aircrafts are moving, where people are running, where businesses are located, if what you're looking for is schools that are located just in remote areas, but those remote areas are just, let's say, 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 6 minutes, or 7 minutes from major cities. If what you're looking for is beautiful parks, if what you're looking for is oceans, flow, lakes, whatever you want to call, mention it, name it, you have it in Canada. Wow. You have so many things, there's just nothing you can't see in Canada. And that is why I like Canada. Okay, so we're going to go to the next step. Something much more important, which I believe so many people will be very happy to identify or connect with, is what we call low tuition fee. When I was looking for admission right from Malaysia to Canada, I was looking at tuition fee. I wanted to pay less. I was looking at what school can actually admit, pay less. We have a list of those schools. We have the list of those schools. We have support. We have controls. We have connections. We have links. And we could provide information to you where whichever school you're looking at, whatever is the constraint, whatever are the variables controlling your choice, controlling your decision, controlling what you want to do, we have a solution for that. We're going to help you. We're looking at research grants. We're looking at several scholarships. Yes, these are very, very important section of this presentation. Research grants are several and scholarships are essential. I know graduate students want research. I mean, graduate students want scholarship. They want grants. They want, you know. And then if you are in the right environment, an environment that can facilitate your ability to win grants, awards, environment that can facilitate your ability to win several scholarships and bursaries, then what are you looking at? Man, I want to let you know that so many people went through graduate studies without even paying anything. And I'm going to explain how that works for you. Very simple. Most supervisors you're going to get, you may not understand this stage. I'm a little bit moving ahead, but I will try to explain. Hopefully you get this. We are not just in a typical presentation. We are just talking. We are just discussing. So I'm just going to go step by step. I'm just going to explain some things to you. Most supervisors, how you can actually go through graduate studies without paying a dime. Most supervisors actually sponsor. Yes, I was paid. And most of my friends, 80 to 90% of my friends were paid. So what happened? I was paid. While I was doing my research, my supervisor was paying me. When I got a scholarship too. I got an entrance scholarship. I applied for several other scholarships. My supervisor was paying me. I was also doing what we call teaching assistants. Let me tell you, I was teaching over seven courses. Seven. Serious about it. Seven courses. Not from the same department. I taught a lot of courses from maths department. I taught courses from mechanical department. And I was also teaching in access program. So many income sources. So I'm not just trying to paint a wonderful picture for you. No, you have to fight for it. You have to work for it. I applied to maths department, applied to chemistry department, applied to physics department, applied to access program, applied to access engineer. I applied. I worked for it. Actually. And you have to work for it. You have to be good. So I got a lot of offers, and I was teaching. Like, so I was teaching over like a week. I could teach seven times. I was teaching like in different department, Mass 1710, Mass 1700, Mass 2715, like as a teaching assistant, which means I do the problems, I solve the questions, I conduct the tests, I do marking, so many things I was doing then. It was interesting, it was fun. And I was also in stress analysis and design, which is top mechanical course. I was also like teaching, demonstrating, instructing, coaching, mentoring. We did a lot of that. And these are part of what graduate studies is. It's gonna be sweet for you. You are an academician. Like, I'm not saying those that just want to do graduate. I'm saying if you like book, if you like book, you know, if you like book, then it's going to be sweet for you. So we were doing that. I did a lot of that, and then at the same time I was doing my research, and at the same time I was taking my courses. So most of the graduate research based programs will require about depending on the configuration of your program, it may require 30% coursework, 70% research. So it's going to vary depending on the school, depending on the curriculum, depending on how it has been structured or configured. So, but I'm just still going to be using University of Manitoba. That's our school. I'm an alumni there. And yeah, I'm going to be using that as a case study. So invariably using our own case, using our own experience as a case study, as a reference, as a yardstick, I'm going to explain to you that it is possible not to even pay anything. How can this work? When you're coming to most schools, I mean, you must have a good result. I mean, first class, you must have a good result. That's a start, because you're going to be competing with other students from other part of the world. So you must have a good result. Like, if you have a good result, you're going to be fine. So, I mean, I don't like seeing students with perfect results. I mean, perfect results. Talking about A's, and then they're just there. Wow. A's, and then they're just at home. A's, and then they're in Ghana. A's, and they're in Nigeria. You want to come out to the world. You want to come and compete with other people. And that is what it's all about. It's fun. So what I'm trying to say is you must have a good result. When you have a good result, you are most likely going to get what we call entrance scholarship. You're also most likely going to get all those scholarships. There are so many scholarships from NSEC, from so many scholarship awarding bodies. All you need to do, be in the system, know what to do. And then after that, you can also apply for bursaries. There's so many bursaries. And then what's it called? There's so many bursaries you can apply to. And so many bursaries you can apply to. And also, while you're doing your program, you can also be working as a student teaching assistant. So you apply to so many departments. Student department, mass department is always employing people. They have 1710, they have 1700, they have 1510, 1500, 1210, 1200, 1010, 11. I taught so many courses, right? So they want people. So when you're there and you know it, you're going to get it. I mean, you should get it. I'm not saying you must get it. You have to apply, you have to follow up, you have to go and see the professors in their offices, you have to see the lecturers there, tell them that you really want to take this course, you want to teach this course, you like this course, you can do this course. I mean, try to push your way into the system. When you are into the system, guy, you're just in. Not in, they are just going to give you a lot of jobs. They say, do this. And that was just what it was. That was what it looked like. And it was awesome. Like, I liked it. I enjoyed it. And I believe everyone should be given the opportunity. Everyone with the background, with the foundation, that have done very well in their results. I mean, first class student and top second class upper student, they should be given the opportunity. They should understand how this works, and they should be able to capitalize on this thing that exists. If you don't know your way around it, don't hesitate to contact us, and we'll be at your disposal. We'll be available to assist you, to aid you, to enhance your ability to actualize this. It's something you don't want to miss. Sorry, I'm taking so much time. I'm making a talk in R&D, postgraduate work permit, possibility to become a PR, like I explained this already. So after your graduate program, if you can successfully finish your graduate program and this degree is awarded and given to you, there are so many other things you could apply for. Postgraduate work permit, it's going to be around 3 years. And there's a strong potential, which is the basis of this presentation is strong possibility, is strong potential of becoming a peer. Well, I'm not going to go into that. I'm going to talk in research and development. We're top in research and development, which here we have the best brains, we have the best guys doing the best research around the world. And I know you want to be part of that, especially those with that background. We are here to help you. So I'm just going to go into types of masters. Types of masters. We have masters of science, masters of art, masters of engineering. We have all lots more other types of masters. Masters of law, masters of education. So masters of science, whichever. Any of them, whichever that is applicable to you, you can harness it, you can get into it. Let us know if you have a problem. Let us know what your circumstance is, what your situation is. Most of the times, most of the people that contact us, we just say, send us your resume, send us your CV, send us your transcript. We want to take a look and do what we call pre-assessment, pre-evaluation to certify, to determine if you are eligible, to determine what the chances are. And from there, we could pick up things. From there, we could throw one or two things there, give you some guide, help you around. I mean, that's just what it's all about, helping people and helping people actualize their academic goals, helping people actualize their goals in life. That is all we're about. And that's it. So I'm just going to go to the next one. Now, I'm looking at the application procedure. Let's say you're out there, you have that result, first class, maybe second class, upper, top one, high one. And then you just don't know what to do. You don't know how, you don't know where to start, what part of the web to go. Don't worry. And we can help you. I'm just going to go through the process a little bit. Look up for the university you want, program of interest, university program of interest, which is proportional to your background, to your experience, what your first degree was, and what researches you've been doing, probably what you've been doing as a job, your work experience, whatever it is. This will determine what university you want to go and what program. If you have a problem with it, like I have said before, do not feel to contact us, and we're able to set you on the right path. We're able to design, we're able to configure something that will be can be implemented. Send us your unofficial resume, transcript. Yeah, you want to send us your transcript and resume. Yeah, we want to look at your transcript, we want to compare with your resume. Most times, most students don't have their transcript, especially students from Africa. Most schools in Africa are not very lenient with giving students their transcript. Whatever the situation is, just let us know what it is. Then we'll know how to go around it. There's always a method, there's always a way to go around these things. You have your transcript on you, just send it to us and we'll take a look, quick look. And we'll tell you what is possible and what is not possible. I mean, we can just project, we can predict. Again, we are not a school, but we have link, we have experience. We can look at it and say, okay, this is going to be a little bit competitive. You can get your way in. Just let us know. And then we'll see how to help you from there. Choose a supervisor from the list of faculty members. Now, there's going to be faculty members, people that are doing research in the same field of your interest. So, which means for you to enhance your graduate studies, for you to come here for graduate programs, you must be able to identify, you must be able to connect with a supervisor that is doing research, that is already researching, actively researching, in the same research area of your interest, which means if your interest is in thermodynamics, if your interest is in car design, if your interest is in modeling, if your interest is in finite element analysis, if your interest is in ANSYS, whatsoever your interest is, you want to look for a supervisor that is already actively researching in that area and also have funding and also is willing to accept you. There are some problems there. And that is where we also come in. We help you mitigate, to help you create a relationship, establish a connection between you and your intended supervisor. All we need to do is to, who is the supervisor? Most times, that's why we like working with schools in Manitoba, because they are really accessible to us. Drive down there, see which of the supervisors, any of the supervisors you're interested in, sit them down. No, sit them down. They sit us down. We talk to them, and then we discuss conditions. We discuss possibilities. We promote you before them. We show them, this is what we have seen about you. This is what we know about you. This is what can happen. This is what you want to do. This is what your passion looks like. And and that you just want to work with them. And then we try to see if we can get you in. Well, it's always at their discretion. We try as much as possible. We try as much as four supervisors at the same time. And most of the time, one works out. That is what it's all about. Then you can, so when you have that settled, then you can submit an online application. So I'm going to recap this. First, you get a school. Second, you get a school and choose a course. Second, you choose a research interest, research area. So I'm just going to go back so I'm not missing. Then you send us your unofficial resume. Right, you want us to help you out. Send us your unofficial transcript and resume. And then after that, you have to choose a supervisor, get a supervisor, because that's going to facilitate your ability to get the admission. And yeah, there are some schools that help you do that, but 90% of the schools expect you to create a relationship with a supervisor first, and get that going and include that in your online application. So when you're done with that process, you want to then submit your application. When you submit your application online, you get an offer later, and that's the next step. You can go and apply for a visa. Well, all our information is about that. We let you, we have authorized immigration consultants that can help you. Like we have that system, support system that can be of great help to you. So let us know what your problems is. Now, after that, your official transcript and references, reference letters will be required. This is going to vary with different schools. Different schools need it different ways, right? So sometimes they expect you to send it directly to them from wherever you are from this. You ask the school to send it to the school. School to school business. It goes from the school, from your school, and it comes to Canada. And it's going to vary. And yeah, the reference letters must come from your professors, your academicians, your academic heads, those that supervised your undergraduate work or your master's work. You want to get those ones on board. Those ones are going to say so sweet things about you. These are the ones you want to bring in, because your reference letter is very important. In fact, here in Canada, reference is it's very important. Elsewhere, we didn't know that references are very important, but here we came to see that there is power in a very good reference. Most things are dependent on the kind of reference you're able to get. You can look at admission letters. Admission letters will be also sent out if everything goes well and is successful. Sorry, I need to put this in my mouth. Sorry about that. You know, the temperature here in Winnipeg is dropping and it's dropping continuously. And sometimes most people are affected by cold and other stuff. So, sorry if I pause somewhere to take this stuff. Okay, that was just taking a break from talking. I'm going to go to the next phase of this presentation. So far, I've told you what the flow looks like, why Canada is the best, why I like Canada, why, and how to acquire admission, and what the admission process looks like. Now, we're going to look at one other important thing, and this is going to apply to, you know, everything I said the first time about all the sweet things I said about getting the offer and getting scholarships, getting other stuff. Of course, applicable to top students, high students, high mark students. Now, all hope should not be lost. There's an option. Certainly an option for those that we are unable to, get it at the first try in their bachelor's degree, they couldn't get a first class. They couldn't get a second class offer. So they couldn't get those A's that are essential, that are necessary if you want to take the part of academic, you want to take the part of research, you want to take the part of graduate studies. Now, but the options are going to be this. Now, let's say you fail to meet minimum requirements. There are so many options for you. You can embark on pre-master's program to boost your chances. Embark on pre-master's program, you can take up some courses. We call it GPA boost via extended education. There are some courses you can register for, just courses. So, and then you take some specific courses that you didn't do well, and then you can boost your GPS chances. It's very important, very, very essential, very essential. And so, which means if your grade was like, say, 2-2, 2-1, very low 2-1, Then you want to boost this, maybe you want to go for extended education, apply to be admitted into extended education. Then you're going to learn a couple of things, and then you're going to try to boost your CGPA, your GPA. And then after that, you can reapply to master's program. So when your GPA already boosted. So of course, this means that everybody can try this. It's just that we are all going to try at different levels. So some people are going to try just directly because they got it the first try. Some people are going to try after, let's say, 1 year, 6 months, maybe, depending on what it takes to get your GPA to a competitive level. Whatever it takes to get your GPA to a competitive level is what you actually need. Now, this is where we're coming. Let us assume this is going to be... I'm going to explain something about it. Just wait. Hold on. Let me run a little bit faster and see what do I have here. Oh, back to the flow. Yes. Okay. Now, so let us assume that you already have the admission. You're already in Canada. You've got the scholarships. You're having fun with research and teaching. And And then what's your career path? What is your study path? Choice of province, we can help you with that. It's a very important variable. Like, let me just explain this structure for you. This is Chivis Edu, that's my company. Like, we are gonna help you with these four squares. Admission process. I mean, we can help you. I'm not saying we must help you. We can help you. We can give you a heads up. But if you want to actively engage us, then you won't have to contract us. That is very easy. Very cheap. We don't charge people. We know we are people that went through the same process. Like, we have to hustle, have to struggle to get ourselves into the system. I first applied to University of Toronto. They worked so hard there. It was coming. It was not coming. It was like, supervisor was throwing me here and there. Then I applied to University of Manitoba. Yeah. I'm just trying to say that we went through the same process, through the same struggles. So we know how it is, and we are deciding to really help people. Very, very peanut cost. So you don't have to pay so much. The procedure is very simple and straightforward. If you want to contract us, you let us know exactly what you want, and we'll see if you have sufficient grounds, foundations for us to help you. And we'll go profile. This is how we can help you. This is what's going to take. Of course, you don't want to think. It's not just all there is. Very little stuff. Very little, you don't have to pay much. Yeah, I'm serious about that. So what I'm trying to explain, this is us here. You can choose to take us out here. So it's not a problem. Like, it's your choice. Like, whatever you want to do is fine. We're just here to help you. Now, the next step is career path. The other step is study path. And we have choice of province admission process. So we can help you in all this. All this will determine your capacity, your ability. All this is going to position you for success. So admission process is the first stage to getting your scholarship, to getting your research sponsorship from your supervisor. So when we take the admission process and you have the right results, we can be able to get entrance scholarship for you, certainly, because the system is a structure. You get your entrance scholarship, at least you have to have at least 3.5 on a scale of 4.5. to get his entrance scholarship. That's going to take about 50% of your school fees. Honestly, your entrance scholarship is up to 50% of your tuition. At about that. Secondly, we have to look at what's the next thing. We have to now look at, you have to apply to other scholarships like UMGF. UMGF, like, this will vary with other schools, but I know from experience other schools have something like this, different types of scholarship. UMGF, IGS. So many scholarships you can just apply through. And then you apply for bursaries, and then you see, and you wait and see what happens. And then you go to your supervisor, let's say you discuss with your supervisor, and got your supervisor into accepting to sponsor you, to pay you while you engage in your master's. That's very good for you. And it means you'll be paid. Most of the times, virtually for the duration of your program. So people secured a 1 year contract with your supervisor, which means your supervisor is going to pay them for 1 year. Some people secure the 2 years. Some people is just infinitely, right? Because they're doing a good job. Sorry about that. So it's going to really, 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 really vary. It's going to really, really vary. It's going to depend on your capacity. It's going to depend on your ability to be able to get into the system and also have the right results to attract the right opportunities. Now, the choice of province is important. Let's say, come in here to study and then you want to stay a little bit after. You want to stay in a place you like. You want to stay in a place that will be easier for you to get a job. You want to stay in a place that is easier for you to stabilize. Probably you're coming with your wife. Probably you're coming with your brothers. Probably you're coming with your sisters. You want to build your family. I know that's what some people want to do. Maybe you already have your family. You want your wife to enjoy while you're going to school. I mean, whatever you want to do, this is a liberal world. This is liberty. This is freedom. You're welcome to do that. I mean, of course, you want to follow morals. You want to follow the laws of the land. Regulations and rules that are used to arbitrate, that are used to legislate the environment where you're staying. And that is what is very important for every one of us. So, we're going to look at what we call study paths. We're going to look at what we call study path. Study path is you're doing your master's, you have to have a study path. You have to say, okay, this is what you're doing, this is how you're doing it, this is the pathway you're taking. You're going to take this, you're going to take this, you're going to teach this, you're going to learn this, you're going to, that's study path. The next one, we're going to help you in determining, we're going to help you in simulating a study path that is rewarding. Simulating a study path that is killing. A study path that will take you there, just at the top, just where we are, just at the top, and just leave the others down. Okay, now the last one is very important. It's called the career path. You see, the research programs in Canada have the capacity to acquaint you, to arm you with what we call research skills. Research skills are certainly different from what we call employable skills. No, sorry, not just employable skills, to what we call to skills that are in high demand in the workforce. For example, if you're a mechanical engineering student, that's why I'm always using mechanical, don't be angry. But if you're a mechanical engineering student, then your plan is to be a design engineer. As a design engineer, you need to arm yourself with certain tools. You need to pack your bags. You need to pack the right things into your bags. Whatever you pack into your bag will determine your position hereafter. Whatever you're able to put in your bags will determine your position and location at the end of your program. It will translate to your ability to settle down fast. There are mechanical engineering students that just come and just do their research and they fail to pack their bags. And then they're able to acquire what we call research skills, but they lack job skills. So there's a difference between research skills and job skills. This may be overlapping in some cases. Some companies are looking for research people, but 80 or 90% of the companies are looking for people that can do the job. Doing the job requires acquiring the skill. You may not learn much of a skill in research, because research, you're just trying to solve a problem. You're reading papers, you're simulating. You're trying to say, how can I get this to work? You're doing statistics. These are all called research skills, right? But job skills require more than that. I'm going to use different case studies. Again, mechanical engineering have specialization. I specialize in what we call controls, automation, and robotics. Control, automation, and robotics. That is my specialization. A control engineer that cannot use Siemens PLC, programmable logic controller, PLC. What kind of control engineer is that? That cannot program ladder diagrams, that cannot integrate, use the right software, set up the wiring diagrams, integrate interface between electronic systems, electronic parts, and mechanical parts. A control engineer that cannot initiate design a control logic using PLC microcontrollers and electronic systems and also mechanical systems. Of course, that's what control is all about, creating on and off applications using what you have, right? So as a control engineer, you need to have these skills. If you need to model some things, then you need to have You need to be able to use some modeling programs, modeling tools. Example, sorry about that. Example, you need to be able to use AutoCAD. You need to be able to use ProE. You need to be able to use Katia. There are so many programs you may have to learn. You may not learn this while you're doing your master's. Masters, you may just be taking some courses, doing research, and then you forget that you need this. Now, at the end of your program, you need to get a job. And then they say they need you to be a specialist, to be very, very conversant with AutoCAD 3D. You need to be very, very conversant with CATIA 4D. They are telling you what they need you to do, but you are done with masters, and then you have research skills, but you are not conversant with CATIA. You are not conversant with AutoCAD. You can't even use Cement Programmable Logic Controller. You can't even use Cement PLC or any of those PLCs that are in vogue. So it's going to frustrate, it's going to undermine your ability to get a job, which is also going to frustrate your ability to get into the workforce and also frustrate your ability to secure your permanency. So which means why you are running your master's program, which means why you have enjoyed the scholarships, why you've enjoyed teaching, why you have done a lot of research papers. Within the same period, you have to be able to factor in a time. There have to be a time where you acquire some job skills. And that is why I like schools like Red River College. That's why I like schools. Sorry, I'm promoting Red River. I'm an agent for Red River, so I have the right to promote Red River anyway. Now, so that's why I like colleges. Most of the colleges is going to arm you. You have short programs that teach you those skills. Some of those skills you have, ants. You know how to use, ant software, heat analysis softwares. You know how to do simulations. You know how to do finite element analysis. You know how to use Automation Studio. You know, there are some tools you must know how to use. So it's also applicable for in the art field. There are courses, there are things you have to know. Things that are needed in the, that are used every day in most companies. You need to know how to use those tools in addition to your research skills. So if you're doing your graduate studies, you must make out time to acquire those skills. You may enroll for them on part-time. You may enroll for them on, you have to use different methodologies, right? So whatever that is visible for you, you want to do that. So what I'm trying to say is just getting your master's is not enough. Sorry about that. Give me some time. Just getting your master's is not enough. You need to pack your bags. You need to get other job skills that's going to help you get the right job. And getting the right job is important. And that will take me to this, back to the summary of this flow. So you're able to come in here for your master's or your PhD. If you already have your master's, then that is good. Awesome. You don't have your master's yet, then you have to come for master's. If you have master's, you have to come, you can come for PhD, you can take a second master's. And then what else? So you, if you have the right results, we could secure your scholarship, entrance scholarship. We could guide you on how you can get, what's it called? Awards, bursaries, even grants, like can position you for that, show you how to prepare grant proposals. And what else? So that's what these are the things you need to know about this. So you're able to get a scholarship, you're able to get supervisor sponsorship, so you're able to get a scholarship, and you're able to get supervisor sponsorship, and you're able to get what else do you can you get from here? Results for master sponsorship, yeah, and all those stuff. So you can get all those stuff in this stage. And you're really going to enjoy yourself. Like you can get research, teaching assistant job and other stuff within this. Very, very interesting. I enjoyed all this. Now, after this one, then you can apply for a couple of graduate work permits. Also, I forgot, within this period, you need to be able to pack your bags, like I said, get the required job skills. Get it. Know that job skills is different from research skills. I've seen so many graduate students. They cannot get job. They are graduate students, but they cannot get job. They've graduated. They have their degree, but they can't get job. Why? Because they know only research. The company, most of the companies may not be looking for research. They already have a system for that. So they want you to know how to use the softwares. They want you to be conversant with these stuff. They want you to be very great at it. Know how to use the right softwares for your program. And as soon as you're able to do that, you're fine. Because that will determine your ability to get a job. Now, at the end of your program, we are assuming that while you were doing your master's, you got the scholarships. While you were doing your master's, you enjoyed teaching. So they were paying you for teaching. Your supervisor was paying you for sponsorship and what else. And you enjoyed scholarships. So while you were doing all this, you also acquired the job skills that you need. So this means that before you come in, you already know what you're coming to. And that is why we are here. When I came in here, nobody taught me that. I learned that from experience. I learned that over time. I had to make up a lot of things. So before the end of your program, most master's program here end within 2 years, some end within 2 years and 6 months, some end within 2 years and 4 months. Mine was around 2 years and 4 months. Within that period, you have acquired these skills. You have gotten all this information that are necessary. Then at the end of your program, you now apply for postgraduate work permit. Postgraduate work permit usually 3 years in length for master's program, for programs above 2 years. PhD programs are usually 4 years, right? Yeah, so it's just going to vary, right? So for postgraduate programs, you're going to get, they're going to give you like around 3 years. So within these 3 years, you need to get a job fast. So if you actually acquire those skills we talked about, job skills we talked about here, so your research experience plus your job skills will help you land a job fast. Write it somewhere. This is a fact. This is simple logic, mathematics, whatever you want to call it. It's just the way it is. Research skills plus job skills puts you on top of the list. That's going to land you a job very fast. And when you get that job, you want to be very serious with the job, because if your plan is to stay a little bit in Canada, you enjoy Canada somehow, you like Canada, you like to continue skating, you like to continue enjoying the city, whatever, with your family, with your friends, whatever it is, then you want to take that job serious. You want to give your best to that job. You want to contribute to that job such that at the end of 6 months, the company is willing to give you a permanent stay. And if you have that permanent stay from the company, which means an extended contract, if that happens, it means can go to the stage we call residency. And the residency, there are so many options. Our authorized immigration personnel are equipped and empowered to provide the nitty-gritty of this process. Though we all have gone through the process, but we have a department. We have personnel that are gone through the training and they understand this very well. So at this stage, you can use any of the options. You can do expression of interest, provincial nomination, express entry, so many options. So what is important is getting this side fixed. Fix this side. Sorry, you can't see what I'm saying. I'm very sorry about that. I thought you were saying that. You fix the postgraduate work permit side and get a job, permanent your stay. I mean, get a permanent contract, and that will pave you for your residency. You can adopt any of the resident settling process, nomination, expression of interest, express entry. Some PhD program students can actually apply directly. So there are so many options. Maybe after 2 years in PhD, you can qualify to apply via express entry. So any of them is fine. So this is what the flow looks like, exactly what the flow looks like. And we can help you this process. We have systems. We have machineries, we have structures in place to ensure that you don't miss any of these parts. You don't miss out in anything in executing this process. How can you start this process today? Very simple. You start from admission. Like I explained in the admission section, for you to start the admission section, you'll send us your resume, you'll send us your transcript, and then we're going to go through this, and we're going to see the visibility. So while we are looking at your transcript, we are looking at the whole process. We are looking at the future. We are projecting the probability, the possibility, the visibility of executing the concept with just your transcript and your resume. I mean, we're looking at a serious-minded individual, a serious-minded, intelligent student that wants to execute this process, that wants to go through this process, that wants to devote his next 3 years, his next 4 years towards actualizing this and having his family enjoy. Simple. So if you want to start this process, very simple, you need to send us your resume and your transcript if they are handy. Whatever you have, you want to send it for us. You want to go through it and you want to have an idea of what your experience is. I want to begin to make arrangements, want to begin to create an enabling environment, want to begin to facilitate for you to be able to actualize that goal, because that is our vision, that is our objective, to see you happy. So when that is done, we are going to work hand in hand with you, pari passu, to get you the offer letter, the admission letter, the necessary entrance scholarship to meet the requirements, or the necessary upgrade avenues, upgrade options. If you are, if you fell short and you're unable to get through one, you're able to get first class, we can create avenues, we can create situations, we can create circumstances, we can create opportunities for you to be able to actualize the goal you desire. And we're able to get you into the system, and then you're admitted, and then you take your master's, we're able to create avenues, provide information, provide support to what skills, to what job skills will be necessary for you, and then that will facilitate the next phase. And the next phase is what postgraduate. When you get to the stage, of course, you're already a matured guy. You already know your way around it. I didn't get anyone to help me. So after my first program and master's, I was already a Canadian guy. I mean, Canadian in the sense, when I mean a Canadian guy, I understood the system very well. Then that was easy for me to just get these other ones fixed. I believe you're going to be fine, because most times experience is the best teacher. People say experience is the best teacher. People say you have to learn ahead. And well, those that learned ahead, if I knew all these things, I mean, guy, I would have been more. But I mean, I've learned a lot, and I am happy that I can use what I've learned to help others that have the same objective, that have the same goal, that are struggling, that are trying. They have tried so many things. So if you're one of the people that have tried a lot of things, if you're one of the people that have applied to several programs, if you're one of the people that have the ambition to advance, to live in a different country, to see what it looks like living with other people that are different from people you've known, if you're one of the people that want to embark on studies, graduate studies, for certain reasons, whatever it is, you want to get close, you may want to get to us. I think our number will be here. Yes. We have 204-891-666. Our email is not here. That's really bad. Sorry about that. But I know you can get my email. Just put this on Google. Put the company name on Google. You're going to get our details. Put it on Google and just hit search. You're going to see our company name is, just hold on. Let me go. Company name. Sorry about that. Sorry. Yep. Oh, fine. This is our company name. Chivis M Ad Ends. You want to put this on Google and put Chivis Edu Services, whatever you want to put, you're going to see a lot of information. From there, you can get our phone number, you can get our our email, you can get everything about us, and then you can give us a call, send us a message. We'll try as much as possible. We're usually very busy people, but we'll try as much as possible to respond to you. Try as much as possible to see what is possible, what is obtainable, what is visible. And I believe at the end, you will be fine. Everyone will be happy. And that, I believe that with this, I'm going to come to the end of this presentation. I'm very sorry, the other presenters are not able to be here due to technical issues. But what is important is this presentation and this information have been shared as planned. And I believe everyone is happy about this at this point. So I am going to be coming to the end of this presentation at this time. And I will be looking at the questions that we are asked, and we received several questions, a bunch of questions. I will try as much as possible to see if I can answer these questions. I know that the time is far spent. We just have about 30 minutes to go. And, whatever the situation is, we are going to see how it is. I believe there are so many people that are supposed to be here today, and because most of our viewers are from Nigeria, what's the objective of this is to be sure, is to be able to ensure that when they come back to this page, they'll be able to view this. I so much like Google, how they have designed this. They'll be able to view what have been done and learn from it, because that's our objective. We had the presentation yesterday. That was our first time on webinar, and it was really, really funny. But when they got back and they were going back to the page at different times, at their own convenience, and they were watching what was done, like, and they were giving me feedbacks, and then I really understood how it should be and how it should run. So it's basically for them to have access to this. So wherever they are, you can share this video at any point in time. It's already on YouTube. Like, it just goes to YouTube automatically to our page. It's easy. You can share this video, help your friends. This is not a twitched video. This is not about video. This is about information sharing. And I believe this has been shared to the fullest. We have exhausted the time we have. So what I'm going to do now is to review the questions that we have and see what can be done to answering these questions. Just hold on a little bit, please. I'm going to check. Just going to look at these questions. I may not be able to answer these questions, or my support system is not here. They all ran away. But let's just see. They know it. Me and them, we know it together. So I'm just going to try to answer just the first five questions I received. The other questions will be answered subsequently when I have sufficient support. So the first question is, how long does the admission process last? Well, this, the admission process, it's like, how long the admission process lasts is going to vary. The admission process is going to vary. Oh, there's one. I just got the message. Sorry about that. Hold on, please. I'm very sorry. yeah, one of the support system is here. I don't know if she's going to be able to give us some of her experience. I don't know how to reach her now. Just hold on, please. Sorry about that. I was trying to talk to one of the support system, but I see her mic is mute. I don't know why she muted her mic. Your mic is mute. She's like, I don't understand. Okay. She's gonna just give us maybe a recap of her experiences. One of the people that have gone through this process and get through successfully in the required time. And I believe her college experience will be very useful to people who would watch this video on YouTube and Facebook at other point in time. I believe she can be candid enough to chipping some things, and before I summarize this presentation by answering the first five questions I have there. Her name is Adenike Hassan. I just saw her. She's running around. Her name is Adenike Hassan, a very experienced fellow. And also, she graduated. She does it for his last. Identify with her. She's in the area of sciences, and if I'm not mistaken, it's something related to remediation and all those stuff. I am going to allow Adenike point of correction, point of order. She will come in. Yeah, Adenike, can you please just give us a recount, just a brief summary of what you want our viewers and those that will be watching this video subsequently, YouTube, Facebook, and other platforms, something very essential you feel they should know, and that would help them actualize this. Over to you, Adenike.
Okay, good morning or good afternoon, I don't know. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you perfectly well.
All right, okay. Sorry, my voice may just sound somehow. I have a little flu. Okay, all right. My experience in Canada was, it's been amazing, right? And I actually came in as a graduate student, and I came in for my master's. And then, yes, I had sponsorship from my supervisor. I'm sure Victor has gone through all this process with you. Because, like, when you're coming for a science course, definitely you need a sponsor, like, to help you pay your stipends and all, like, to pay stipends throughout your master's program. But one thing I always tell people now, definitely, I always want people to have a better experience than I had. One thing is that don't ever work with, when you get the opportunity to come to Canada, don't work with negative people. Don't work with people that will always discourage you and tell you, I've been here for 5 years, I've not gotten it, so it's not possible. That's not true. Sometimes we find ourselves with such people, and then at the end of the day, we realize that somehow, they just made our journey slower. So what I advise people, like, when you come to Canada for your postgraduate studies, and you have maybe a postgraduate studies that is going to be over 2 years or 2 years and above, like maybe you're going to do a master's, and master is supposed to be 2 years. Most times, this it's not exactly 2 years. It's like maybe 2 years and 3 months. It's very few people that finish on that 2 years mark, right? So, and then you have work experience from Nigeria. My dear, I advise that if you have work experience from Nigeria, just start applying for your nominee. Use your work experience to start applying for your PR. A lot of people will discourage you and tell you, wait till you graduate. Don't listen to them. Because if you have work experience from Nigeria, no matter how long the nominee process is going, the PR process is going to take, it will just fall in, no matter how long it takes, you eventually have it as you're finishing your program. And the best thing that can happen to any international student is not to be anxious about anything you are applying for with CIC. If you get to that stage where you have to be checking your mail every morning or checking your mail every month, it brings anxiety. Maybe at that time, you need this work permit because you need a better job. You need this PR because you want to relocate to another province because of one thing or the other. When it gets to that time that you are anxious, it could lead to something else. So I advise people that when you have, if you have work experience from Nigeria, as you come into Canada, just rest for like 3 months and apply for your nomination, because your work experience from Nigeria will count for you, and you can apply under the general stream. Now, under the general stream, it may take like maybe 1 year for you to get nominated. It's still fine, because ideally you'll still be in school, right? Yeah, so when you get your nomination, Then after that, you can now apply to federal. You will still be in school. And I tell you, by the time you graduate, you would have gotten your PR, which makes very good sense. That at the end of the day, you may not even need a postgraduate work permit. But it's a different thing if you do not have a work experience in Nigeria. Yes, then you cannot wait when you're done school, work 6 months, yeah, and then like follow the normal process. You understand? So and then after that, that's one of the major challenges like present that people that I went through, and I had, yes, I had work experience in Nigeria, and then people will tell you, just wait. Yeah, so it doesn't really make sense at all. Then another thing I just tell people is that it's not even just about you listening to this webinar. It's also about maybe your friends, your younger ones. I had someone recently that I was mentoring back home, and I was telling the person how to get a first class. Now, I told the person that I don't have time to waste. If you know you're not going to listen to instructions, just leave me alone. But I was so excited because, like, this past week, everything I told her, she followed through. And today she's a first class student. She sent me a message on last week that she's a first class student. And also, coming to Canada is not even just about being a first class student. You see people that do not even have first class. I've seen people with third class that come to Canada and they do all these certification courses, which I'm sure Victor would have told you that certifications to me is even better than even coming for a master's. If you come for a certification, you get a job easily, you're done school faster, and you get your PR faster. So don't get discouraged if you do not have a first class or you do not have a second class upper, as it were. But like your certification also, it's good. And from my experience, sincerely, these people that do certifications, they get the job faster. I don't know how they do it. But I think another thing I also look at as an individual is when you're taking this certification. I was discussing with Victor the other day that if I have to take a certification or I have someone to advise, I will look for those certifications that have internship or co-op programs. Because when you do co-op programs in industries, whether you like it or not, that's a Canadian experience. So yeah, so Canadian, yeah, so when you do courses that have co-ops, it gives you an edge, because most times the companies retain you, so you get your job directly. One, even if they do not retain you, on your resume, you will, when you are putting your education, you will write the company, you will proudly write that company, and you have an edge over someone that had the first class, that had the master's and did not do co-op. You understand? Yeah. What these people look at is experience. What they look at is experience. And I'm telling you, experience matter. And I've seen the advice, and I know why the employers also have look at experience. I tell you, where I work, yes, I have a master's, but they prefer experience. Now, there were some people that had more experience than me, and sincerely, on the job, when I started, they were better than me. But definitely, I had to learn over time. But because they've been doing it, and me, I was just going to school and reading. So the only advantage you have when you have a master's is that you learn on time. That's just the only thing. You just learn on time and you go with the flow. But I'm sure if my employer was supposed to rate me for the first week, rate us, they were going to give those people like higher percentages, because they were just doing it with ease. Me, I kept asking questions because I wanted to do it right. You understand? So like, don't get discouraged if you do not have a first class or a second class offer. Even if you have a first class or second class offer, you can still do the certification. Do the certification that has a co-op or internship. Get the Canadian experience. Make sure that's the first thing you put on your CV after writing all those objectives, blah, 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 blah. Just make sure you put that qualification you have in your co-op or your internship. Those are the things that like give you an edge over some people that have read, have PhD, have all those on. Those people, they don't really care whether you read or, you understand, read all this word, do your postdoc. They don't really care. But what they look at is those little experience. And also, when you come in for any program, try to get a part-time job. I'm telling you, you are Nigerian, so you can cope with anything. You understand? Try to get a part-time job. Like, no matter how the job is, like, just get something doing. those little things add to your experience. You may not even be working 20 hours a week. You may be working just like for just little time, but you can, you, if I'm sorry that I'm generalizing that we are Nigerians, but like maybe most other, we have other people from other places. I'm sorry about that. But yes, if you're definitely, if you're coming from another country, you should know that initially it's going to be like rough a little bit, then before you start gathering yourself. So you should just come with that mindset. Just don't come with that mindset that I'm coming to play and relax in Canada. No, you're coming to find your feet. So when you're in school, try to get a job. People will tell you it's not possible. I even hate that word. Don't let anybody tell you that it's not possible. One thing I like about Victor is that he's always telling me there's a way around it, there's a way around it. Even if at the end of the day, you may not do it, but you may always, the first thing he'll tell you, we'll work on it, we'll work on it, we'll find a way around it. That's just it. So just make sure that anything you want to achieve in Canada, when you talk to A, it tells you it's not possible. Talk to B, it's not possible. Keep talking to people until you see that right person that will give you the drive to go on. And I know that in Canada, there's nothing impossible. I'm telling you, not okay, with God, there's nothing impossible. And even in this place, we always, just like Victor will say, you will always find a way around it. You always meet somebody that will help you to do this. You always meet someone that will make that burden lesser for you. So that's the major thing I just want to say. And I know our time is running, and definitely I even have to go to work now. So, yeah.
Yeah, thank you, Ms. Adenike Adekunle. That was wonderful and wonderful contribution. This has been very insightful. And you actually covered a lot of things that I missed along the way. And that is awesome. We appreciate it a lot. I believe our viewers have benefited from your experience, from what you've gone through. And I believe it's going to go a long way to help them actualize their goals. Quickly, I will just we are just going to take just two questions. Other questions, we are going to specifically reply to those that have asked the questions. We had wanted a situation where some people benefit from the questions that other people are asking, but because of our schedule and because of our time constraint, we are just going to respond directly to them, and then we'll just pick just two questions. The first question on the list was, how long does the admission process take? If you're coming for graduate admission, it's just going to vary with the department. Most times you take about, because first you need to get a supervisor and other stuff, and then if the committee need to review other stuff, sometimes it takes some time. And so what happens is it could take like in space of 1 month, 2 months for you to completely get your offer letter. You have to still mail your transcripts, and most times it takes some time. So within 1 month to 2 months, you get your offer. If you are coming for, let's say, certificate program like she was talking about, postgraduate certificate program or just a certificate program, sometimes we get your offer in 2 weeks, sometimes 3 weeks. It just varies with school. From school to school, province to province, it's going to vary. So, so it's going to take, like, it's going to, it depends on when you start, it depends on how fast you're able to submit your documents, how fast you're able to provide all the requirements and submit a complete application to the school. This will determine when your offer will be issued. And then after that, other steps, other processes follow. I'm going to look at the next question. Next question is, what is the estimated tuition fee? Obviously, that is a tuition fee will vary from school to school, right? So it's like for graduate studies, it's still going to vary. Let me use Manitoba as a case study. For tuition, your first year tuition fee is around, most times around $8,000 to $9,000. $8,000 to $9,000, but you're still going to get an entrance scholarship, which is going to bring that fees down. So I believe, like in my own time, I got an entrance scholarship, and I had to pay 50% of my first year tuition. And the second year, you don't have to pay like everything. You have to, I think we call it continuing fee. You have to just pay continuing fee. So you just pay for the first year. The other years is just continuing fee. And then the continuing fee was really, really small. It's around $300 or $300 every semester, or 400 or 500, I don't know, around that range, but it's not more than 500. You have to pay like around $500 every semester added to the first year of your program. So, which means what's important is the first year. After the first year, continuing fee. And I know we did so many things, like we had a payment arrangement. So we are just paying little by little. We were just taking it from, for me, I was teaching a lot of courses then, and I had a payment arrangement with them. So they were just taking my fees from my income. So I didn't have to see what was going on. My fees were just paid automatically from my employer's account. So, and that is what it looked like. So it's not a very complex process. And the tuition fee is something that is like something that's not hard. So also, if you're able to get some of these other scholarships, like I know Nike Adenike, I know she got the UMGF scholarship at the time. So that's, and then she was really, really earning so much. And she was earning from her supervisor, earning from teaching assistant, earning from from UMGF scholarship. Like that was what it looked like. She was having a nice time. So it's going to vary with people, from people to people. And yeah, so that is what it looked like. That is it for the second question. I believe we will, like I said, we are going to respond directly to those that have asked the question. We got a lot of about 60 or 60 to 70 sign-ups for this seminar, this particular session. And I believe that everyone has obtained the value for the time and they will be spending to watch this video after now. Thank you so much for this time. Like I said, if you want to get in touch with us, just go to Google and then you type our CVSM at end, or you can go through this video, the other earlier part of this presentation. You can reach us at 204 891-6666. Calling outside Canada, you want to add +1 204 891-6666. You need to email us, you want to email us at info@chivismagency.com. And we'll try as much as possible to respond within 48 hours or less. Thank you so much for the time, and God bless you all. Yeah, Adenike, thanks a lot. We are going to be stopping this broadcast any moment from now. I'm going to see you off air. Okay, all right. Okay, bye-bye. See you.